Are you fucking taking a video? Now holding this heavy fucking head? What is wrong?
Hi, I'm Jesse, and this is my lovely wife, Siwi, and we are Tribal Soup Project. Welcome to another episode of Fair Antics, Simple Fare for Simple Folk, a low-carb cooking show with a bit of a twist. And what is your little twisted mind going to do for us today?
We are going to have... Wait for it.
Dun, dun, dun.
Pizza. Low carb.
Get the hell out of here.
No.
Well, no, not literally. I was just being like, get the hell out of here. Really? We're going to have pizza? Could it be that we have found a substitute for pizza? Stick around. Check it out. Find out for yourself.
So I am super excited to be sharing this recipe with you guys because one of the things I miss the very most is pizza. So the first hurdle that we had to cover in regards to actually making a pizza was the tomato sauce. The easy fix for that is to make a homemade Alfredo sauce, which is basically just a butter, parmesan, and garlic sauce. And the ingredients for the Alfredo sauce are a cup of heavy whipping cream, parmesan cheese, 6 tablespoons of it, finely grated, 1/4 teaspoon of nutmeg, 4 cloves of minced garlic, 1 tablespoon of butter, and then salt and pepper to taste. So the first thing we're gonna do is we're gonna go ahead and grate up our 6 tablespoons of parmesan cheese. I'm going to go ahead and put a saucepan on about a medium-high setting, and I'm going to go ahead and add the butter to that, 1 tablespoon of butter, and once that butter starts to melt, I'm going to go ahead and add my garlic in with that. So now my butter has started to melt, I'm going to go ahead and add in my 4 cloves of garlic. Now I'm just going to go ahead and saute that in the butter for 1 minute. Alright, so now I'm going to add my 1 cup of cream. It's important when you do this recipe to not let your cream come to an actual boil. And now that I've got my cream in there, I'm going to go ahead and add my parmesan about a tablespoon at a time, stirring the mixture constantly. It goes just like that. Now that I've got all my parmesan in there, I'm going to go ahead and add my 1/4 teaspoon of nutmeg to the mixture. And stir that up too. It's going to take about 10 to 15 minutes for this to thicken. You want to stir it frequently so that it doesn't come to a boil. And then once that thickens, you can go ahead and add your salt and pepper to taste.
What's the matter? Got a mouthful of my hoof? What, cabbage got your tongue?
I don't know why it's so funny.
What's the fun?
I don't know.
I don't know. I'm a tree. Cabbage is gonna come out of her nose. There'll be no colors in the kitchen for you, young lady. It's like you had some giggly water.
Oh my god!
Yeah, say, I like cabbage. Say it.
I love cabbage. To cover the biggest hurdle of all when figuring out how to have pizza while on a low-carb diet was obviously figuring out how you're going to make pizza crust. Luckily, us low-carbers do have a saving grace, and that saving grace just so happens to be cauliflower. In addition to the 4 cups of cauliflower that you will need in order to make your pizza crust, you are going to need 2 cups of mozzarella, plus another cup or two of mozzarella to put on top of your pizza. You're also going to need about 3 teaspoons of oregano, 4 eggs, and then your other toppings in addition to salt and pepper to taste. We are going to be putting pepperoni, mozzarella cheese, black olives, bell peppers, and sweet peppers, and then of course our delicious Alfredo sauce that we already made. So in order to make my cauliflower pizza crust, I am going to be using a food processor. If you do not have a food processor, you can as an option. I have seen people who actually grate their cauliflower using like what I use to grate the Parmesan cheese, but I'm going to go ahead and use the cauliflower. And I've got a head of cauliflower, an entire head of fresh cauliflower here. I've already removed the big stems, and I'm just going to go ahead and chop it up a little bit more finely before I put it into my food processor. It does better if they're in slightly smaller pieces. I'm going to go ahead and begin adding my cauliflower a little bit at a time. And I'm just going to pulse it as I add it in.
Thank you.
cauliflower all chopped up in your food processor. It should look like rice is what it's supposed to look like, as mine does right here. And I'm just going to go ahead and transfer this into a microwave-safe dish bowl. So I've got my cauliflower in the bowl, and I'm going to go ahead and cover it. And I'm going to stick that into the microwave for about 10 minutes to cook it. Do your knee crunches. Are you wound up? Are you sure? Okay. Action. The fucking... That was so much action. That was so much action! Too much. Calm down. Calm down. Take a breath. Are you calm? So now that I've got my cauliflower cooking in the microwave, I can go ahead and preheat my oven to 425. And while it's cooking, I'm going to go ahead and cut up my peppers. Cauliflower out of the microwave, and I went ahead and put it into a large mixing bowl. And now I am going to add in my 4 eggs. And like I had said, this makes, if you use a fresh head of cauliflower, it makes about 4 cups, and that's how many you need for this recipe. So I've got my 4 eggs cracked. I'm going to mix in my mozzarella, my 2 cups of mozzarella, my 3 teaspoons of oregano, my garlic, 4 cloves minced, and then my salt and pepper. And I'm just going to sprinkle a little bit of the salt and pepper in. And then I'll give that a good mix. Okay, so now that I've got it all mixed up, I'm going to go ahead and take a prepared baking pan. And I use parchment paper. You could use olive oil, butter, however you do your nonstick, do it that way. And I am going to spread this out on my baking pan. So now I'm going to go ahead and stick this in my oven just like this for 25 minutes or until the crust is golden brown. Once it has been in there for that 25 minutes and the crust is golden, I'm going to take that out and then I'll add my toppings at that time. Alright, so my pizza crust has been in the oven for 25 minutes, And now I'm ready to add my topping. I'm gonna go ahead and put on my homemade Alfredo sauce. Now I'm gonna put some mozzarella on. Then I'm gonna put some more toppings on before I finish it off with the rest of the mozzarella. Until the cheese is melted. I feel like I'm being assaulted.
I wasn't assaulting you.
I thought you were putting spices on.
You did.
You can have spicy, baby! And our cauliflower pizza is finally done.
Dun dun dun.
Dun dun dun.
Hey, thanks for watching this episode of Cauliflower Pizza.
Faux pizza, if you will.
Right. Click subscribe down here in the corner. Hit like, share it with your friends. You're going to want to share this for those people that are on low carb diets, because this is something good to know. See us on social media. Check out our website and all the stuff we're doing. Buy a t-shirt. Things like that would be real helpful.
Until next time, guys. Happy cooking and happy living. Bye.
See ya.